Hello everyone, welcome back to part 3 of how to make a zombie raid game in Scratch. And so today I'm going to be adding an animation and making a stronger zombie. So off camera, I did this. So when they bump into the other sprites. I think I might have done that in the last episode. If I did in the last episode, then this is just a review of what we did. I made it so it says touching buildings or sprite 3 or sprite 2. So either touching either of the other enemies, they will bump and turn away. So if I can get an enemy to bump in. Yeah, you see how they touch each other? They move away, and then they start turning. I never said zombies were smart. Oh, and I also set the shoot speed back to normal. I actually had fun playing around with this. So, let's make the shoot animation real quick. It's not gonna be hard at all. Not hard at all. Just like that. And we want them to start off as costume 1. Forever, if key space pressed, which costume into costume 2. Change Y by 10, or actually have it move negative 10 steps. Wait 0.05 and move 10 steps. So it should do this. Boom! Wait, 0.7 for me. You want to make sure to subtract 0.05 from your actual thing so it looks good. Now, mine is moving around a lot, so I'm going to change this to 4. Yep, just like that. And I can kill the zombies as they spawn. That is very accurate direction. I'm surprised how accurate the direction is. Okay, so let's make a stronger zombie. So if we copy and then delete this, we want to try to make sure to center the normal sprite, the circle. We can ungroup, copy, paste. No, flip vertical. I'm gonna make a angry zombie. Now, I'm just gonna have it like that, so it's not too scary for any little kids who are watching this. But for you, you guys can make it more scary or less scary. Honestly, you could really just have this, and maybe make the eyes a little bit bigger. But I'm gonna keep it like that, so it's not scary at all. Oh. Actually, I want to see what happens when I do this, I see, we need to have them. Start. We want them to start here, otherwise they won't spawn. Yeah, okay, so they just turn. So let's make them 5% smaller. So now it's like this. So now we got a giant zombie. I want to see what happens when he does this. So yeah, he doesn't turn when he hits a building, but he goes wee. Okay, let me add that back. The thing you want to make sure with your game is that they aren't too big, otherwise it won't work. They just can't get through the alleyways. You want to make sure that the alleyways are large enough. So for me, I'm going to be making this size 90. Okay, I don't want to make that smaller. Actually, if I make it just a slight bit larger, will that work? No, it doesn't. The giant zombie is still too large. You could even zoom in on it, which is what I'm doing. Oh, but you also want to... Then if that happens, you want to make sure that you fix the where they'll spawn. Because otherwise they just turn and disappear. Stop. So the bullets still go through, which we don't want. So we're gonna take this, copy it over. We'll want to set the health to large to make sure that it's larger. And I'm going to make this guy, because he's larger, he'll be slower. Yeah, I'm gonna make him move half as fast. But when they do touch the buildings, do want to make sure that it moves the negative amount at the same. Or sprite 2, we want to change that. Or sprite 3, then later we'll add or sprite 4. And sprite 4 will be something else that, so you see how they move slower. So I'm going to just have, so we're gonna have it like this, so when they touch the sides, they turn around. So look, when they touch that edge, they just start turning instead of deleting. Yeah, let's fix that. Well, actually, we'll change this to be a boss later. So we can copy this over. You can actually delete this original sprite. Ugh. Why is this still? I've told it multiple times to go right there and stay right there. Finally, it's working. And I'll have the giant zombie spawn less often. So now you can shoot all of the zombies. So it still doesn't die. Yeah, and so for that, we want to make sure that if this is touching sprite 6. So now it actually gets absorbed. Huh, that's weird. Why does it only take two hits? That's weird, but okay. Maybe it was just a glitch. That's a lot of giants. And they take a long time to kill. Now the last thing that I'm going to do is a death animation. Goodbye.